So, hello everybody, my name is Svetlana, so it's my first time here, so it's cool to be here, and I'm glad to be the part of the party. So, as for my co-speaker, well, I hope he's on his way, yeah. you know, he likes canoeing, and I took airplane, he took canoe, and I'm here now, and my co-speaker might be in the middle of the ocean. So, today I'm gonna talk alone. I'm gonna talk about the things I'm sure you know well. It's all about shellcodes, zero days, memory corruption, vulnerabilities. So, we are in 2012 now. So, why should we care about shellcodes at all? We all know that it's pretty old technique, too old for Web 2.0, too old for some cloud stuff. And if I remember everything correctly, such attacks were first published in 1999. Also we can look at some Microsoft security reports about malware propagation, and it says that the number one reason for malware propagation now, it's not zero days. It's surprisingly user unawareness. So, and the role of zero days is less than 1%. As for endpoint security, okay, it deals well with known malware. And in such circumstances, why should we care about unknown at all? But let's look to the other side of the coin. Yes, memory corruption is still there. We still have a huge bunch of code written in C, programmers still making mistakes, programmers still making vulnerabilities in their code, in their products. And we remember Microsoft report about vulnerability in remote stock protocol. We also know that tools like Metasploit framework and related to it is widely used now for some black hat communities, by pen testers also. We shouldn't forget also about targeted attacks of critical infrastructure such as planes, trains, water pumps. It's really serious, and we should care about it because it can lead to human victims. So it's worth to detect it as fast as possible. And about endpoint security again, it's mostly signature based, and there's nothing to do without zero days. Okay, that's another point of view. So that's why I should care about shellcodes. It is CTF competition. During CTF games, teams usually write zero days with the help of automatic tools such as Metasploit and others, or even manually from scratch. So, during the process, all game network is full of exploits all the time. If your team is able to detect such exploits and analyze it, you can gather some profit from it. Like, you can gather some ideas from other team, you can gather, you can increase your defense level. Another point of view, we all live in digital era, and what is true that we trust almost all fields of our life to digital devices, such as cell phones, laptops, and some other. We trust them, bank accounts, health records, personal and private information. We share it also with social networks, cloud providers. And the problem there is that such devices use a huge amount of different software written by programmers who work under pressure of time limitation, resource limitation, managers who prefer quantity and not quality. And here is IBM statistics. It's increasing the amount of vulnerability disclosures each year. So, as you can see, the trend is not so positive. Okay, what do we have about shellcode detection methods? So, mostly it exists in research papers only. If someone knows available open source tools, you can tell me. I would be very happy. So as about tools described in research papers, we can divide them into two classes. There are static analysis methods, dynamic analysis methods, and hybrid also. So the most common techniques used by static analysis are listed here. It's signature matching, control flow graph analysis, instruction flow graph analysis, knob-slit detection, and also methods of abstract execution. Dynamic analysis method presented by emulation and automata analysis techniques, and hybrid analysis methods could use all of those techniques. So if we look at those methods, we can notice that none of them can detect every type of shortcodes. So if we want to detect everything, we can simply try to execute one algorithm after another, but it would be extremely slowly. It's a boring slide, let's keep it. So now I'm gonna to try a little bit science. That's why shortcode detection is feasible at all. In contrast to viruses which are rich with features, shortcodes has certain size limitation and structure limitation. Given the set of shortcodes detection algorithms, why don't we try to construct a classifier which will be optimal in terms of false positive rate, execution time, and at that point we shouldn't also forget about false negative rate. So as the first step, we try to identify some shortcode features. It could be generic, it could be specific. Some of them could be detected only by static analysis. Some of them could be detected by dynamic analysis only. And some examples of them are listed in the current slide. So given such set of shortcode features, we can divide shortcode space into several classes. And in such a way that one class can include one or even more shortcode features. Okay, here's an example of what I said in two previous slides. We could name such specific features as, for example, correct disassembly from each and every byte offset, or existence of multi-byte instruction. And, we could name such common features, for example, like correct disassembly into a chain of at least k instructions, and so on. Totally, we identified 19 classes, and here's a significant remark that none of existing shortcode methods provide complete coverage of identified classes. During analysis of existing shortcode methods, we noticed that almost all of them could be presented like some kind of combination of elementary classifiers or detectors of specific shortcode features. All of them use some common steps during their analysis, like disassembling stage, reconstruction of control flow graph, reconstruction of instruction flow graph. It seemed reasonable for us to implement shortcode detection library in a way like described in the current slide. Here is the main idea of our hybrid shortcode detector. So we tried to construct optimal data flow graph from elementary classifiers implemented in shortcode detection library. And if some classifier concludes flow to be legitimate, such flow doesn't pass to the other classifiers. So, and if we try to put classifiers which runs faster at the top of such topology, we could reduce legitimate flow as fast as possible. So that's how it works. We are given the set of elementary classifiers. And at the next step, we choose from them such classifiers which provides complete coverage of shortcode classes detected by entire set, which are optimal in terms of false positive rate and execution time. So then we construct a lawyer of resulting graph and repeat that step. So we end up with decision-making model, which analyzes all output from elementary classifiers and concludes the flow to be legitimate or to be malicious. One of the important goals of that work was to minimize false positive rate. We noticed that we could achieve such goal in simple linear topology when we execute one elementary classifier to another, and there is no flow reduced in such case. And there are relation results. We compared hybrid topology with simple linear topology in four different data sets. It was exploit data set, exploits generated by Metasploit framework. It was benign Windows and Linux binaries, random data, and multimedia also. And here's visualization. So red line stands for linear topology, blue line stands for hybrid topology. As you can see, on some datasets, hybrid topology is more effective than linear, up for 45 times. So there is a couple of use cases for hybrid classifier. It can be used such detection and filtering tool for 0 days in the network. It also can be used in CTF competitions, as it could help to increase defense level of team and could help to gather ideas from other teams. And just a second, it's a little bit demonstration. Okay, so you can download the tool from GitHub. Build them. Oh, sorry. So it is a case of detection shellcodes in the network. So we can see, catch something. In use case of detection shellcodes in the files. We are using exploits generated by different models of Metasploit framework. As we can see, we are detecting different classes of shellcodes, like plain shellcodes, shellcodes which contains knob sledge, and also which contains the cryptome. So I'm done. Good news, everyone. So God's maybe now detected. So. So now it can be detected up to 40 times faster than before. And you can download our tools and use it. So if you have any questions, here's some information about me and my co-speaker, Dennis. And also information about research papers used in the current presentation. Thank you.